I'm Carrie Van Zanny, and I'm the director of the Jasper County Conservation Board. The Red Rock Prairie Trail has been part of a conversation since back in the early 2000s, maybe even the late 1990s. It was a abandoned rail bed, and we did some trading for the first part of it. The county did some trading with the railroad to get the first part of the acquisition, and then the rest of the purchase happened in 2016 with help from the Iowa Natural Heritage Foundation. So it's kind of been a long time coming, and it's exciting to see that construction is going to begin. The first section that we're starting on here in April of 2022, it should be done by the end of summer 2022, and you should be able to ride on a concrete trail from Monroe to Neil Smith Refuge. The second phase from the edge of Prairie City to Mitchellville. A lot of it depends on funding. We're always begging for money and writing grants, but I would really hope for that part to start in 2023 or 2024. Once we make it to Mitchellville from the edge of Prairie City, we see some really close connections to the Gay Lee Wilson Trail in Altoona. That's only about 5 miles away. There's a little less than five mile connection from Mitchellville to the Chautauqua Trail. And then the other direction, you'll see about a 10 mile connection to get from the edge of Monroe to Lake Red Rock. If we can get a connection to the Des Moines Metro, I know when the Chautauqua connected to the Des Moines Metro, we saw a huge influx in people riding that trail, and the little communities along the way saw so many people coming. So I'm hoping the several hundred thousand that ride that trail every year will be what we see here, especially if we can get that last connection to the metro.
In Polk County, the Trestle to Trestle Trail Bridge in Johnston is being replaced. Construction is already underway there. This new bridge will replace one washed out a couple of years ago by ice jams. And if you'd like to keep track, you can watch the construction webcam. There's a link in the text portion of this story. Also in Polk County, on the Great Western Trail, a new tunnel is being built. That construction is underway already, and there's a bypass in place. Both of these projects should be completed by the fall of 2022. In Warren County, look for 2 miles of the Great Western Trail just south of Cumming to be replaced. Money for this project comes from a COVID relief grant. In the city of Des Moines, about 5,000 feet of the Neil Smith Trail from Euclid north to the Sailor Creek Bridge will be reconstructed. It'll be widened from 8 feet to 10 feet. Also in Des Moines, work on levees will close portions of the Meredith, the Carl Voss, and the John Pat Dorian trails. Look for the link in the story that will keep you updated about those closures.
Mike Wallace, Director for Dallas County Conservation Board. Our project for 2022 is actually starting on the west end of City of Woodward, and the City of Woodward, with some funds of their own and a grant that they received, we're going to be bringing the west end of the City of Woodward trail section into town and meet up with the existing High Trestle Trail trailhead. Yeah, there's lots of phases. This is a 9 mile project, and we have probably by the end of this year, we'll have half of it done. You know, we can build the trail as fast as we get the funds, and unfortunately, the trail funds and trail grants aren't like they used to be out there. And typically we have a state rec trail grant opportunity and a federal rec trail grant opportunity. And we apply for those every year, but that gets us about one phase per year, which is about, you know, 1.5 miles per grant basically. And so that's why it's taking longer than what everybody would have anticipated. But we're plugging away as fast as we can and, you know, still looking for additional contributions.